So let's say you're making a landmine for a combat game. Now, most people, what they would do is they'd make their part, they'd customize it to whatever they want for our landmine. I'm just going to make mine anchored, and then there we go. Looks pretty good. Let's change the material to like metal or something. And then they'd make a script inside of the part. Now, this approach may seem really simple and easy at first, but it does have some flaws. But let's go through it and see exactly what those flaws are. And we'll say local, to start, we'll say local part equals script.parent just to get our part. And then we'll say part.touched connect function hit, like the hit part. And we want this landmine to explode when it comes in contact with another humanoid. So in order to do that, we can just say local character. This will be the assumed character of the humanoid. Will be hit find first ancestor. The ancestor is like the parent or the parent's parent or the parent's parent's parent. Like whatever, how long it is. It's just whatever is above it in the hierarchy. We'll find the first ancestor, which is a model. Because all characters have models. And we'll make sure the character exists by saying if character. Then we'll define a humanoid. And the reason we're doing this and not a player is because we want this to work against like zombies or NPCs or whatever. And then we'll say character. Find first child humanoid, and we say if humanoid, then let's just explode the landmine. And we can do this by saying local explosion equals instance.new explosion. Then we can say explosion dot position equals part dot position, and then explosion dot parent equals workspace. Then we can just destroy our part by saying part destroy. So this is a nice little landmine implementation. We can run this, step on the landmine, we utterly explode. And that's pretty cool. But let's say you want to change some aspect of your landmine. Like, instead of getting humanoids and exploding them, you want to take down their health by 25 points or something. Now, right now, that'd be really easy. You just go in the script and change it. But what if you were to duplicate the landmine, duplicate it some more, and maybe you want to make an entire map with hundreds of landmines? You don't want to go into each of those scripts and change all their codes individually. Now, I've done this before. I made a game a long time ago where I had a bunch of cannons, and whenever I changed the value, I had to destroy all the scripts and copy and paste the new ones, and I hated it. And I knew there had to be a better way. And the better way is using collection service. So collection service is basically a way to centralize your scripts for a situation like this and keep all of your code in one spot that you can change on the fly whenever you want. So let's get rid of all of these extra landmines. And then let's move our script into service script service. So before we refactor the scripts, first thing we want to do is tag our landmine and make a landmine tag. And the whole idea behind this is collection service handles tagging stuff in Roblox, and since, you know, tags are just identifiers for collections of objects, that's how the whole name goes. And I have a convenient plugin for this named like the tag window and tag editor, and I'll have a link to that in the description that you can get. And so once you have it, just click it. Mine appears here, and you have a few options. You want to create an add new tag, and I'm going to name this tag landmine. And then the process of tagging an object is kind of weird. You have to select it, so select it either in the sidebar or in the workspace, and then click on the tag, and then just deselect it. And now it's tagged. There's no indicator or whatever. It's just tagged. And then you can check that by going to worldview and the plugins. And it has this nice little highlight, and you hover over it, and it says, like, it's part of the landmine tag. And that's pretty cool. So you can also go to the settings and click tagged instances to also get a nice little dialogue with all the tagged objects in the workspace. So now we can go into the server and start refactoring our code. So at the top, we want to add a reference to the collection service. So I'll say local collection service equals game get service collection service. And then what we want to do at the start of the game is make all the parts with the landmine tag into landmines. So basically just adding this part of code. So the easiest way to do that is let's get rid of this part definition real quick. And let's make a function make landmine. And we'll take in a part. And then we can indent this. And add an end at the bottom. So this is a function that will do what we just showed with the script. But in a nice little function. And now we can say for, I'm just going to use an underscore since I don't really need this value. Say for underscore landmine in pairs collection service get tagged. And then get tagged takes in the tag name. And just copy this tag name from here. Mine is landmine. And this returns a list. And that's why we're iterating through it via a loop. And so for each of these parts, and by the way, this will return the instance that's tagged. In our case, it's going to always be a part. If it's not a part, then it's probably an issue. We just need to say make landmine of the landmine. So we just make our part into a landmine. So right now, as long as our part in the workspace is tagged, this should work exactly the same. So let's try it out. There we go. We step on our part. And we die. And that's exactly what we want to happen. But our game is going to be dynamic. We're going to have landmines spawning in and out depending on the situation. And you can defuse a landmine, for example, and so it wouldn't explode when you touch it. And collection service has convenient methods for that as well. So let's say we want to add a new landmine in the middle of a game. The way we can do that is by saying collection service. Get instance added signal of a tag, and we'll put our tag in as landmine once again, and then we'll connect a function that takes in the instance that was added. So what happens here is whenever we add a new tag to a part, it'll fire this event, and we'll get a reference to our part. And all we have to do is say make landmine of our instance. That's new. And then for diffusing, it's going to be the same sort of idea. We'll just say collection service, get instance removed signal of landmine once again. Oh, whoops. Then we'll connect a function that has the instance that was removed. And the way to do this will be a little bit more complicated. So what we're going to have to do is go up to the top of our script, and we're going to define a list and call it connections and set it to a blank table. And if you don't know about tables, I have a video on that. And I will put it in the card in the top right of your screen. And then what we want to do in the part.touched block is say local connection equals part.touched. And so a connection is just a little handle to this event. And when we're done with the event, we want to get rid of it. So in our case, we want to stop our landmine from exploding. We want to shut down this event. We want to disconnect it. And in order to have the ability to get that event later down the road, like in the function down here, we'll have to add it to this table up at the top. So what we're going to do is we're going to say connections with an index of part will be equal to the connection. So this is a really convenient thing to do, where we set the index to our part. So all we have to do down here is say if, we first need to make sure it exists, obviously, if connections instance, then, I keep on spelling connections wrong, then we can just say connections instance disconnect. And what this will do is this will prevent our landmine from exploding when we touch it, because the touched event will no longer be listening because we disconnect it. And since we're using a dictionary here, we can easily index our stuff and make sure it exists and just disconnect it whenever. So let's try this out. Let's go create another part in our workspace. I'm just not going to use that one because it'll still be tagged. We'll make a completely new part and we'll make it a little bit sized differently. There we go. So this is our second part. and we can name this test, so we can test it. And then we'll go back in the service script, service, create another script, and then in this script, we'll just say local tests equals workspace.test. And then we also need the collection service. And I'm just doing this in a separate script to show that it does work globally, which is one of the key benefits of something like this. So we can say game get service collection service. There we go. So now we can wait a few seconds, like, well, let's wait 5 seconds, then say collection service, add tag, and this shows another API of collection service where you can just add the tag to the instance. And all of the functions of our collection service, they're very intuitive and they're very simple to understand. I'll have a link to the API documentation for it in the description if you just want to read through it and find some useful stuff. And so we can add our tag to what instance we want to add it to the test part, and the tag name will be our landmine tag. And then this will prime the landmine, it will be active, and then let's wait another, let me build that up, let's wait another 5 seconds, and then say collection service, remove tag from our instance, which is test, and we'll remove the landmine tag from that instance. And by the way, you can have multiple tags per part, which makes the system even more versatile. So let's play this. Now, if we step on this part, we don't die. But if we wait a little bit, we die. So now let's try that. But instead of waiting a little bit, let's wait the full 10 seconds. So it becomes a landmine, then it stops. And it reverts back to its normal part state. And then we can just step on it normally. Let's say we like diffuse it in a game or something. And you can see we can step on it without dying. And that's great. And you can see how not only can this be used for landmines, and not only can it be used for multiple landmines. So this one's already tagged, and we can duplicate it a few times to just add more landmines without adding more scripts. And all of them work as they should. And I've used this for vehicle systems. This is very useful in component systems, like NIT. NIT's component system uses these collections of tags in order to add components and remove components. And it overall makes larger games, or any games in general, more organized and easier to deal with, because you have to deal with less scripts and they're in a more centralized location, like server script service. And that's about it for this video. So I hope you enjoyed. If you did, make sure to like and subscribe and join my Discord server. The link is in the description. And I encourage you to play around with collection service, see what you can do with it. Super powerful, super useful. I use it in almost every game that I make, and it's really good. So I hope you have a nice day, and goodbye.